Now, the most accurate weather team in Florida, ABC Action Weather.
All right, an update here on Hurricane Matthew, and we'll continue to bring you these throughout the day, of course, as we check in on current winds right now, 120 mile an hour winds. This storm, not as strong as it was, now a Category 3, still brushing the coastline here. The main threat continues to be, and it has been for a while here, not just the significant wind, but also that push of water along the shore there. That's going to bring at times of high tide as well a significant storm surge, which of course is the deadliest for some of these storms. There we go, as it hugs the coastline, headed up towards Jacksonville by tonight, right? So this thing is not going to stall or anything. It's going to keep moving to the north. It's just so very close that it's going to cause some significant damage as it does that because of its proximity here. Now, the hurricane force winds extend out about 50, 60 miles, so staying a little bit further offshore makes a huge difference as far as how much damage we get, which is what we've been talking about the last couple of days. Also this, 33-foot waves. You imagine that? That is headed in. Now, this is not a storm surge. We're not going to get 33-foot storm surge coming in. Just an indication of what is being generated by that push from the east from the storm, so that by later today we could be looking at anywhere from 6 to perhaps as high as 9 feet of storm surge, especially to the north. So we'll watch that very closely as all our friends across the east will. But as we've been saying the last few days, for our area, this will continue to be a tropical storm threat as far as the winds. 30, 50 mile an hour winds certainly could cause some power outages, and that's still the main threat, I think, for our interior counties, especially a little further to the north, perhaps there as well, but really concentrated as you are closer to the stronger winds, which are closer to the storm, which is a little further east now, right? So the yellow, that is just some gusty winds as we head through what later today. I don't think we're going to have an issue. Been saying that for the last few days in Tampa and St. Pete. I think we're good. As far as the rainfall tallies, really not all that significant until you get closer to the storm, where we have these rain bands coming in. Those are the ones that are going to contain not only hurricane force wind gusts, but as they push further and further west, tropical storm force wind gusts for us, and that could, of course, bring down some power lines and interrupt your power, which is why it's always important to have a good backup for several days of not having power here. So 30, 50 mile an hour winds is what we're doing today here. Again, not a big flood threat for us, not a storm surge threat. Obviously, this thing is on the other side in the Atlantic, so that's not an issue. And of course, the East Coast, if you have friends and family there, as a lot of you do, hurricane force winds are still going to be a problem, along with that surge, which will continue to be a threat throughout the day. We'll bring you continuous updates on Matthew right here online and on air.